you've been part of the game for a long time. Mm-hmm. First of all, you don't age, but I will say, musically speaking, I have followed your career. I think one of the first songs I ever played was Cool Waters.
Yeah,
your song, Cool Waters.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you have continued to reinvent yourself, something that young people always fear to do because you feel I'm leaving this particular bracket of people away from me. You've done it effortlessly. And as you did that, you paved the way for many other people to get a platform. Shout out to Piera, by the way, as well. You paved the way for other people. And women, supporting women, you being on that platform, creatively speaking, when people are too edgy for mainstream broadcast or mainstream media, so to speak, you were there to give people a platform. She gave me a gig at Blankets and Wine, and I was just, you know, I was just like, okay.
Oh, look at that.
I had a small set, and she gave me the show. I think that was about four years ago.
Yeah. Your project
that
was
been?
So dope.
Thank you.
Yeah, your project's so dope. And I don't know if your listeners know, but like Monique can really sign.
Oh, wow.
Sign
don't
me.
We all know?
We're here every day.
Yeah.
We know.
She and we really are the backup, so.
Yeah.
But how has it been? You know, you founded Blankets and Wine, My Peeps in Kampala, Lava, Kigali.
Yeah.
You've done things people would only imagine.
Yeah.
Tell us about that.
Well, on the one hand, it's extremely fulfilling. I feel that I am in my purpose. I think that we have to create space for whatever is considered alternative. Because in fact, I don't think it's that alternative. When you look at how people really are in their real life, like nobody eats chapodondo 3 times a day. Like you switch it up.
Yes. Yeah.
So I really believe in like switching things up and that the platform exists for anybody who is like really working on their craft and wants to switch things around.
Yeah.
So there's that side of it. But it's also a lot of work. And it's like years and years of sacrifice. For many years, I wasn't paid for doing Blankets because it's like the money comes and the first thing is like all the artists have to get paid, all the suppliers have to get paid. Then you have to invest money back for the next event to happen. Mm. And then after that, if there was something left over, I would get. And that's a thing that people just don't understand. There's no shortcut to building a business. It's really just one small step at a time. A lot of it was very overwhelming. I had no training in business when I started. I still, everything I've learned sort of kind of on the job or from the internet.
Yeah.
And so for me, it's like, I'm a musician. I just want to make some songs.
Yeah.
And now here I am, like, I have to learn, like, KRA and I don't know what not. It was very overwhelming for, and I was really, really young when I started as well. So there's been a lot of learning. There's a lot of work. There's a lot of sacrifice. And for it to be where it is because, you know, the thing that I understand fundamentally is Blankets and Wine is a service, right?
Yeah.
And it's a service to the artist. It's a service to the...
I love that.
I know,
to the audience. This is what I feel. It's like my life is a service to others. And my service right now is to these people who create and to create the space for them to be able to create. And in the process, I also get a place in... in that mix of things.
Exactly.
So as I lift them, they also lift me. So
Did you have a plan for Blankets and Wine to be this big?
Bigger.
Because bigger, like it's huge. I mean, I remember we started with you, Mike. I used to come to when it
Tiana.
Was at like it was
small
cute. And cute. We come with our dogs. The next thing it's becoming big. The next thing it's big and nobody wants to leave. Eh?
Yeah.
You're still stuck there with your little dogs and then you decide like
no more dogs.
Because now the dogs are being squeezed in between people, like there are a million and one people.
Yeah.
Like did you ever think it was gonna grow that big?
Yeah.
I really
I feel that when the vision for Blankets came to me, it was very complete. I was very clear from the beginning about what this thing is going to be and that I really wanted a platform that is going to give, it's the superhighway for African artists, that they will always have access to markets and to audiences, and we're going to give them that platform. It's going to connect East and South, East and Central. I really have had a huge vision for it, and the vision came sort of all of it.
Yeah.
So what's been happening is the manifestation of this, right? So, I'd say that maybe 2013, the January event, I think that's the one we had Liquid E. I remember really having an out-of-body experience and like watching everybody and having the sense in my head, like the thing that you had wanted to create, it has happened.
Yeah.
And from this point, everything you do now is replicating.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I'm convinced, I'm certain about where we are. Now we're in 3 countries. I'm certain that we're going to get to the vision that we wanted, which is to be, you know, in as many African countries as we can. 10 is our little magic number.
Yes.
And then we see what happens after that.
And I think what's brilliant is her answer. You know, for her to say, yes, I believed, yes, I saw it.
I know.
Yo, what up, how you doing? My name is DJ Piera Maken, and thank you so much for watching Let's Talk. Now, if you want to catch up on the missed episodes, you can watch them right here. And remember to subscribe right here.